Hey, what's up, guys? So before we get started, please do me a favor and go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe to this page. Now, what we pretty much doing here, we're doing a deposit color using 20 volume, you know, equal lift, equal deposit. And it's on darker hair, so we're going to use dark brown. But I don't think I showed on camera. I'm going to use a little hint of a brown as well with the red in it to give it that different contrast in the hair color. So I'm mixing the color up now, and I think I'm going to go ahead and show you guys the consistency that you would want the color to be before applying. Now guys, sectioning and subsectioning is very important. You want to make sure that you're making small parts so you can saturate each section of the retouch. We're only doing a color retouch, so you can go ahead and make a decent amount of section, and you're not going all the way over into the previously colored hair. So you're just going to keep parting up the head and applying your color on both ends of the hair, which is going upwards and downwards of the hair, so you can make sure you're getting full saturation of all the outgrowth of the previous hair that was not colored. And I know it may not look like it, but if we had did a close up on her outgrowth, she's pretty gray in at the roots. So that's what we pretty much doing, is going ahead and covering up the grayness in her hair and making it all solid and giving a little hint of contrast of the brown and red like I spoke of. Thank you. Now, I don't know if I'm the only one. It may just be me, but I like to use a little cotton to, you know, put around the clients. So, color won't run and leak while they're processing under the heat. So, this stops the color from running and making a mess, pretty much. So, I use the cotton and put a bag over so the hair could process it all together and evenly. Now with blow drying, I typically try not to go down to the ends of the client's hair to dry, because by that being the hair that's been on the scalp the longest, it's the most vulnerable and the most fragile. So I try to keep the, you know, keep that more moist at the ends until the surface is pretty much done, or just let that air dry on its own. But I try not to really go all the way down to the ends of the hair. Yeah, I know a lot of you guys probably like, why you ain't just round brush her, you know, get her out of there. I absolutely hate round brushing hair. I hate it. I just can never get into it. Even in hair school, I couldn't get into it. Couldn't get into it in the salon. I'm one of those that prefer not to round brush. Thank you. as you can see, I'm pulling the damn towel up off of her, you know. And I'm going to put an extra bar because, you don't ever want the cape to touch the client's flesh, you know, his skin, due to irritation. So you don't ever want that to touch your skin and sanitation purposes as well. And, I just proceed on with services after that. Thank you. So guys, we are reaching the end of this video. Please do me a favor and like, comment. All comments are welcome, you know. And go ahead and subscribe if you would like to see more videos. Let me know what you want to see. Thank you.